Our next etude is simpler. It's about what it takes to play a leading role, what it takes to play a supportive role, what it takes to play a leading role and a supportive role, and when to play which role and when. To a jazz musician, that's what makes a good leader. And we hear so much about leadership these days. You just heard a trio in which all three players are more or less equally dependent upon one another. But now, they're going to morph into what's known as, quote unquote, a rhythm section, backing a soloist. Their role here is mostly supportive. They're gonna make me sound really good by listening to me, filling in holes I choose to leave, or echoing me, or prodding me, adjusting their support as my choices get busier, or more sparse, louder, or softer, and so on. But even though I'm now the leader, I'm gonna find spots to let them instantly step into the spotlight and then let them instantly step back into supporting me. And that, I have to tell you, is the most exciting and most beautiful part of it all. The key in all of this is how well all of us listen to one another, especially in an improvisational setting. And improvisational settings aren't obviously just restricted to jazz. All of you that are in management know that you're in an improvisational setting. It's the only way a team can move forward when you don't know exactly what your goal is, okay? Like I said, it's all in the music. So guys, we're gonna play a little softer. And I might take two. Kill this mic, guys.
Thank you.